2021 has been a season where differences between teammates have been emphasized to an extent, with Russell consistently reaching Q2, leaving his teammate behind in Q1, with Schumacher consistently out-qualifying Mazepin, Hamilton being miles ahead of Bottas, and Verstappen clearly ahead of Perez. So far this season, we have seen more gaps between teammates than expected. But when teams like McLaren, where we expected closer teammate battles, fail to deliver it yet, the biggest teammate battle is shaping up in a place it was not much expected. I am talking about Ferrari and specifically Carlos Sainz and Charles Leclerc. Let's take a deeper look why. Leclerc sits at the 6th spot in the championship standing, with Sainz closely behind in the 7th spot. Leclerc has a best finish of 4th, while his teammate has a best finish of 2nd. While Leclerc has 2 pole positions this season, he also has 1 DNF in Monaco. In terms of points, there is nothing to separate them, with Leclerc having 62 points and his teammate closely behind with 60 points. In terms of average finishing position, it is even closer, with Leclerc having 6.88 and Sainz with 7. In 2020, when it was announced that Sainz would move from McLaren to Ferrari, it was seen by many as a stupid move, looking at how McLaren had performed that season and how much Ferrari had declined in 2020. Norris even joked, saying that he will wave at Sainz when he drives past him next season. But Sainz more or less has disproved his critics with how well he has settled with Ferrari and how better Ferrari has become this year compared to 2020. In Leclerc's opinion, he has more in common with Sainz than with his former teammate Vettel, as he is more close in age to Sainz. Sainz, on the other hand, mentioned about how Leclerc was able to bring in solid performances, especially on Saturdays last year with a weak Ferrari, and how he is eager to work with him and possibly even learn from him. While Leclerc had a tough teammate in Vettel last year, Sainz himself has had some real competition in Norris and Hülkenberg before him and Verstappen before that. What he has proved over the years is that whatever he lacked on one lap pace in Saturday, he more than makes up for it on the whole race length on Sunday. And that is a crucial asset for Ferrari to have, as Leclerc is anyway very strong on a Saturday. Together as a team, they ensure Ferrari maximizes its point scoring ability on both days. I see Sainz versus Leclerc as a battle between the unstoppable force and the immovable object. While Leclerc has made Ferrari his home and got very comfortable in that red car, Sainz has been basically living in the factory in Maranello, learning the Ferrari way inside out, and that is very much Sainz's approach. Sainz was the hardest worker in McLaren, and he is probably the hardest worker in Ferrari currently, and the Tifosi love him for what he is. But regardless of how they both improve as drivers this year, their teammate battle do not matter much until Ferrari builds a championship winning car. The regulation change next year could change things, but it is probably a couple of years down the line at least. But for this year, it is still anyone's guess who comes at top. But what we know for sure is if any person comes out on top, the other will be very, very close behind. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit that like button, consider subscribing to the channel if you like to watch similar content, and stay tuned to I Am Formula for everything Formula One. Until next time, take care and stay safe.